Hello and welcome to Neodrome. I'm Tim Claypole from www.iwtfilm.com and I'll be introducing the fabulous 1997 sci-fi flick, Cube. Cube is a low-budget, high-interest flick from writer-director Vincenzo Natali. Cube tells the tale of a group of strangers trapped in a booby-trap labyrinth which houses a series of cube-shaped rooms. Strangers have no recollection of how they got there, how they get out, or who put them into the Orwellian prison. The film doesn't boast a roll call of well-known names, but this adds to the whodunit nature of the plot, as everyone is at risk. It stars Morris Dean Wint, Nicole DeBoer, Nicky Guadagni, Andrew Miller, Julian Richings, David Hewlett and Wayne Robson, who all give great account of their unhinged, twitchy characters. Each character is vulnerable, and director Natali plays a collusive game with the audience that revolves around which of the inmates meet the demise next. Not only is the audience kept guessing on the who, but also the how. Lethargic Worth and Wince Incendiary Quentin carry the can in many scenes as they spark and flare off each other. Guadagni plays edgy very well, which heightens the nails against the chalkboard atmosphere. There's a sense of unease and mistrustfulness amongst each character. They all have a purpose but an unwillingness to coincide and learn from each other. The set design runs in the background as a fantastic optical illusion and acts as a leveller for the characters. The traps are set and every new room comes with a new and deadly challenge. This is not overplayed and is only used when required. The real deadly nature of the plot is the threat of a trap rather than the trap itself. Cube writers Andre Bujelic, Natali and Orphan Black's Graham Manson keep the dialogue at the heart of the proceedings and even offer a nice nod with the characters' names based on real prisons. Now and again the script jumps into rather offbeat dialogue that may have sounded better on the page rather than the screen, but on the whole the script is crisp, precise and builds tension with each heated word. Fear, suspicion, paranoia and desperation, as the poster tagline says, oozes from the script and the players. Watching Cube, you'll be reminded of a host of director offerings. It smacks of Lynch, Kubrick and even pre-lightsaber George Lucas. The film is claustrophobic, nervy and at times quite chilling. The camera trickery offsets the low-budget nature of the film. It not only plays with the cards it's given, it even has a couple up its sleeve. We may have seen some of the same plot characteristics since Cube, 10 years later, but Cube provides a more than stable and upright, chilling and uneasy stepping stone between 1960s claustrophobic Twilight Zone episodes and the modern graphic horror thinkers such as Saw. Cube was followed up 5 years later with a quite solidly titled Cube 2, Hypercube, and then a prequel, Cube Zero, 2 years after that. However, the real genius is in the original. So sit back and enjoy tense and quite brilliantly innovative Canadian gem, Cube.